Hey everybody, it's 41. Welcome back to Legend of Dragoon. We made it through the Forest of Winglies, and now we were sent to the former capital of Kadessa, which is now ruins. And I also got some key magic, which I'm going to definitely be using. But I just wanted to get this item, because I wanted to see if this is the item I'm thinking of. And it is, Dancer Shoes. So, Dancer Shoes can be equipped by, I think, any female, which is a good thing. Very good thing. So you give someone like Rose, turn them into pretty fast. Or you give them to someone like Maru and turn her into a freaking speed demon. Also, a little less defense, but that's a very small price to pay. Honestly. So who do I want to give it to? You know? I really don't know what I want to give, who I want to give it to, truth be told. Give it to Rose, so now everybody's basically going to be in the 70s in speed, except for Dart. But because it's a foot armor and not an a jewelry equipable, I feel it's better than Bandit's Ring. Because it's not as easily replaceable. That's the key. Because there's so much heavy competition in the jewelry department, especially when you can factor in some items I haven't even gotten yet, Bandit's Ring just doesn't make the cut. Dancer Shoes can make the cut for a while. These guys will not make the cut either. Hopefully I remember how to use Hardblade. That accomplished what exactly? Well, that was a funny battle. Anyway, let's move on to the next area, shall we? So as you saw, I went through this area and then decided to double back because I really wanted to get that one chest, which turned out to be a good call. So we can actually advance further and see more of the history of these ruins. And, well, I guess see a little bit of the former Wingly culture from 11,000 years ago. And suffice to say, it's going to be ugly. Very ugly indeed. So as you see, Colosseum. That's definitely a Colosseum. This looks like it was definitely based off Roman history. Everybody knows the Colosseum in Rome. And it's true. And Maru explains that back then. Bloodsport. Death matches and blood sports, yep. Humans, dragons, giganos. It really was the Colosseum. And I guess you could sort of see with Maru that she's much more sensitive to the fact that she is a Wingly and her Wingly heritage than she lets on, and that's why she is way more, she's way more, outgoing and energetic and cheerful and carefree and the like. I think it really is to compensate for the fact that she realizes that who she is and she's not proud of what is there. But you know what? 11,000 years ago, I mean, how long is long enough? You know, you do feel bad, but it is nice that you see a different side of Maru. That's one thing about Disc 3 I think that really does help, is that you actually see a more serious side of Maru when you absolutely desperately need to. The only question I have is that, is it possibly too late? Because you know how first impressions are such a huge thing in interpersonal relationships? Well, the same thing goes with movies and video games. First impressions mean a lot. And I upgraded Madness Hero. So, seeing that, I think really does matter. And it's actually a good reason why I despise you know who, but when it comes to Maru, I actually view her in a more positive light. That's why. Also, I don't know if I want to fight the fairy, because I'm afraid I'm just not going to hit hard enough and then deal with... deal with a dancing ray, which is going to hurt Rose like a mother. Anyway, enough with that. Let's just dispatch these guys. Hey, it succeeded! The spirit succeeded! Now let's fight the puck and see what happens. Oh shit. You can see when you're dispirited pretty easily, because you can just see the posture is that of, like, it's almost like being a zombie in a sense. You're lethargic, you have no energy, you feel like you're just like barely hanging on, you're on spaghetti legs, things like that. You haven't seen Marus Trigun transformation, I don't think. Well, that'll change. Not exactly my favorite transformation of the bunch, but it's cool to see it. And Rainbow Breath, I might as well just show it off. I can do it right now. There is a healing point in this dungeon, so. Rainbow Breath is very useful, because it probably will be the first curative magic you get that actually heals everybody. I mean, to no surprise, you will see a version of this with the white silver Dragoon from She Who Will Not Be Named. And it's supposed to be 100% cure, basically a souped up Rainbow Breath, but I'm not actually sure. I don't believe it actually does 100% HP cure, even though it says it does. That's one thing I never understand. How did I miss that? With that in mind, I should point out one thing that you probably are not going to see a level 5 Light Dragoon. So, I probably can spoil this now. Didn't get it. You probably won't see since you won't see it, I might as well just tell you. Also, pretty cool pose. And for once, Maru didn't fall flat on her face. The level 5 specialty magic you can learn is a dragon. Well, is for every Dragoon is a dragon summon. It says on that one, it'll do 100% attack all. So it attacks all enemies, 100% strength, which means it's wore down by definition. And you heal for everything. So it's a mass heal. Also, here's that healing point I was telling you about. And now that we got that out of the way, now we have a much-needed save point. And the reason it's much-needed is because there's two bosses. You know, choose which way to go. I'm going to choose both ways. And you really should go both ways. The last thing you need to do is to run into both bosses without getting one of the best items in the game. And also a new blade from Dart. That's key. So let's go right first, because I believe right leads to the weaker of the bosses. And we'll end up in a little bit of a challenge where we'll be pursued by all of these spinning heads. In a little bit of a challenge, but you have to run. You have to run through this one. If you don't, you have to fight them. Yada yada yada. And then they come back. So they try to pursue you. But as long as you race over to these things, you can eliminate one of the spinning heads and also eliminate a part of that barrier. And that's the challenge. It's not much, but it is a challenge. It's something, I guess. So, regardless of which split you go through, there actually is a puzzle aspect. This one isn't much of a puzzle aspect, it's more like a racing aspect, but there is a challenge. The other one is more of a puzzle challenge of sorts. Thank you, Spinning Head, for not moving. You make life easy for me when you do that. There also is going to be a unique aspect to one of these bosses where I'm actually going to do something very unusual. I usually go into battles fully prepared, and that means full Dragoon spirits. For one of them, before I go in, I'm going to fully drain it, and I was not looking where I was going, and I just got jumped by a spinning head for doing that. Ugh. Great job, me. Run into a corner, you get jumped by a spinning head. I totally thought that one through. Anyway, spinning head, still a spinning head. Treat it with its due respect. Or one-shot it. And you won't suffer too horribly. So as I said, when you defeat one of these, all it really does is just cause another spinning head to go pursue you. The only true way to get rid of them is to hit those pedestals. And success. So with that in mind, we will no longer be pursued by the spinning heads. That is a good thing. Anyway, no enemies here. Let's move on to the next area. And this was the room I was thinking of. There's a series of elevators here, which don't really lead to much, but it is a good place to get some amazing items. And that is going to be my pursuit. Also, you gotta be careful about those ones that just simply fall like rocks. The same gnome duo again. Yada yada yada. Anyway, let's fall like a rock. And we want to get over to that chest over there. Make sure to mash the button, otherwise you're not going to do it. And we'll get ourselves the Mind Crush. A fantastic equipable item for Dart. That is a drastic upgrade to the Heat Blade I've been wielding around. Remember, I never got the Falchion, so that kind of hurt me. But there should be one more item I want to get. I believe it's in this room. I just need to wait for that thing to come back. In order to leave the room, you simply go to the right and take that one floating platform all the way over. But, of course, that's not what I'm doing. I know what I want. Oh! There it is. And if I'm asked to drop an item, I will drop an item. Because I believe that is the power up up there. Which is a definite yes. Please be the item in question. There it is. I cannot undersell the power-up. Like, I should say, I cannot oversell the power-up. The power-up is indescribably a good item. Because it's an infinite use item, and it makes you much more powerful. It really does break the balance. I don't want to say it's like having Dragoon Spirit, but man, oh man, can you imagine putting that on top of a Dragoon? You'd be unbeatable. It really is that fantastic. And of course, it adds to your defense too, so it makes you tougher. Definitely a critical aspect of being powered up. Mental ailment, gang. Oh, anger! Anger from the jump, really? Oh, you little son of a bleep! Okay. 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 That's the way you wanna play? Is that the way you wanna play? Oh, you fucked up now, kid. You fucked up now. I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you. Come here. Come here. There is no way to end with you. You're going out first. God dang it. I can't get the 5. Oh no. Oh no. You are not staying up. You are going down now. You pissed me off. You've made for fearful preemptively.
Die.
That is an unforgivable offense. Because preemptive fear is horrible. Okay, anyway, with that out of the way. Now the rest of the fight. Puck and A. That spinning head made a very big mistake by making me angry. And I treat him accordingly. Alright, anyway, that said, let's go to the next area. And even though we're at 20 minutes, do I want to do the next thing? I don't know. Honestly, I don't know. I think this leads to the boss I'm thinking of, but if not... If it doesn't, I have an opportunity to get out of it. Okay, that's the key room. We don't want to go here yet. That's the room that leads to the really hard boss. Which means I went the wrong way this whole time, which is fine. I got the weapons I wanted. So because of this, I have to go all the way back to the healing room and take the other split. There's also the save point there. So with that in mind, I think this is a great opportunity to stop this part. We will take care of the first boss, but I might make it a short part because the second boss is going to be a long one and a doozy. See you guys later. For the Warrior signing off.